everybody trying to be a big girl this morning and do what she's supposed to do. Ain't that right? Good girl. Y'all, she is... I'm doing one-on-one training with her today. Let's see if she'll stay. This is hard for her. Stay. You stay. Sit down. Sit down. You were doing good. Come on. Come on. Let's do it. You stay. Her. You stay, baby. We'll let y'all know how it's going, and we'll post it to True Kennels. So, y'all, I'm doing my personal morning hygiene, my face scrub, moisturizer, all of that good fun stuff. And look who got tired of sitting in one spot and laid down, y'all. At least she's still where I told her to stay. And I gotta get more treats. I ran out of treats so that I could, so I can reward her for listening. I find it easier to separate them versus trying to do everything with all of them at one time, because they're distracted by each other, and because they are now just starting to get trained and disciplined, it's only fair to do it separately and then bring them together and see how they do. So far, so good. She's chilling. She's not running around tearing up anything. We'll see how the day goes. I'm gonna just let her be free with me all day. Usually, you know, they have their outside time, kennel time, and because I'm usually either in my living room with it gated off or in my garage, they have all that free time. So we just gonna let her pretty much walk around with me all day and see how she does. Ain't that right, Dundon? Dundon, ain't that right? I know.
Somebody's still by my side, y'all. Try not to give her too much attention, because the more attention you give her, the more things she starts to do. But we don't see. She did get up and run out of here one time. I went and got her, brought her back, and corrected her. No punishment, no discipline, nothing. Just went and got her, told her to come back.
The problem is, y'all, we transitioned from the bathroom to my bedroom so that I can clean up in here. The more I move around, the more she wants to move around. I wanted to sit on my ottoman, but when I sit down, she immediately wants to jump on me. So we got to work on correcting that. I'm trying to work on her being calm, being still. Hey, nobody, sit down. Thank you. Good girl.
Y'all, what do y'all think? Do y'all think Lauren is Prego pregnant? Do y'all think Lauren Dundon is pregnant? Hold on.
Hey, she just getting a little bit of one-on-one time. You know, leave her alone. Quit whining. Quit crying. I got you. Okay? Quit smushing your face through the bars. It's not your turn. It's not your turn.
Lauren. Dundon. Y'all, we working on training with Dundon this morning. Y'all tell me if y'all think she pregnant. Stand up, Dundon. Dundon. Okay, let's look, y'all. Turn around. Let's look. Turn around, baby. Look.
Do y'all think Dundon is pregnant? That's...
Stay. Hey, you stay, baby. I'm trying to see your body, and you want to move when I move. See, that's the body, y'all.
Let's look at the back side. Her little cooch is swollen. Hey, when I move, y'all, she move, of course. Come here. Stand up, baby. Come here. She like you all up in my privates.
Here we go the next morning, you guys.
She did okay yesterday morning for the first 3 hours. It's Saturday morning around 6 a.m. Like I said, I let the dogs out. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. I don't want to play. Okay, you can lay down, I guess. Long as you be still and stay. She's picking it up, y'all. We're about to go in the garage and do some cleaning and mopping and just see how she follows me throughout the day. I'm gonna do her, probably train her for the next week, and then I'll take Nipsey and do the same thing, one-on-one training. They are smart dogs, but they are also stubborn as heck. So, like I said, yesterday went well all while she was alone. So we got to work on focusing and listening, even when she's with her husband and the puppy, with Nipsey and Diddy. So we'll see how it goes. But she chilling. Wherever I go, she go. And my whole goal is for her to be able to be free as much as possible around the house. Not anywhere that I have carpet, but so far so good. No, her and Nipsey really don't have accidents. It's that puppy that I'm training, y'all. So I set my alarm for every 2 hours to go off so that I can let him out. And because of that, I'm letting them out also more frequently. So far, so good. 6 a.m. in the morning, Saturday. I'm sitting in the bathroom on the toilet. Yep, sitting on the toilet. TMI, I know. But I just want y'all to see how she follows me everywhere. Everywhere. If you have a dog at home that does the same thing, let me know in the comments.
All right, you guys. So what we're doing right now is Dundon and I are sitting in a garage, my female English bulldog, and I like to do their grooming either outside or in here, where I can just sweep it right out the door, because it's a lot of hair that sheds. It's best to at least brush them. I try to do it every day, because that means that there's less hair in my house when they do get to be, you know, about. So I'm about to, the thing about English bulldogs also is, when they're younger, yes, they have a lot of energy. Like Diddy right now, Diddy is going on 11 weeks and he is getting on the big dog's nerves. So Nipsey is fed up and Lauren, Dundun is fed up. So last night, I'm trying to transition him over to their side of the kennel. Right now he has that divider. And that divider, he still has too much space on his side of the crate. Now that's a new home for them. I got it off of Amazon. I paid $100 for it. It is a great size. We probably could fit two more dogs in there, but I won't ever crowd them like that. We're trying to think of a setup now as to how we want to set up the kennel, where it's going to be, if I'm going to get maybe a nice size she shed in the back. Yes, bitch, a she shed, which I'm leaning towards, with a split unit in here for heat and air. It'll be clean, of course, because who you messing with? It's me. They'll have, you know, it'll be really nice in here because I also will probably work in there. So, I also like being in the garage, y'all, because my kids not coming out here to mess with me. They will not, especially if it's a really hot day. Now, when it gets hot, I'll put on that outside unit for a while. The air conditioning, one of those, what do they call it? The portable. I'll turn that on a while from now, every now and then, but it's just too hot for them. So, I love it. Don't come out here. But back to the dogs. So yeah, we'll either do a she shed or we'll set up a kennel in the garage. The thing about that is, though, we plan on getting some expensive cars, so I kind of want to park them in here, but it would be a nice space to convert. I would do the floor over, you know, a nice little I will still do concrete, but you know, the designer concrete, you know how you can do it with the glitter in there and all of that. It'll be so nice. It'll I can get, you know, set up some nice kennels in here. Y'all know me. It'll be clean. They'll be clean. And it's best to keep your English bulldogs clean. That's where I was trying to get to, y'all. English bulldogs are a lot of work. No joke. So keep that in mind. Do your research before buying any breed of dog. Any pet, but dogs. Do your research. Did I know they shed a lot? No, I didn't know they shed a lot. Did I know they fart a lot? Yes, that was part of my research that I found out. But it's only when you give them something different. I don't feed them table food. I stick to my raw and kibble. I might introduce something new raw to the diet, but and that's when you're gonna get those gases that, I mean, you could be sitting in the living room, everybody's chilling, and all of a sudden you smell this foul smell. Yeah, it came from your dogs. It did. So you have to be careful what you feed them. Anything can trigger allergies in them. Don't play with their food. Don't switch up on the food. Don't try to get something cheap unless it's something that you've researched and it has good stuff in it. Otherwise, you know, find you a good, nice brand and go ahead and drop them coin. They are part of your family, and in my house, they are an investment. So I want to make sure that their innards are all good. So that's why I introduce supplements. Right now for Diddy, I'm substituting him with goat milk because of his mom. You know, he's not getting mom's milk anymore. I may have told y'all this before, what I put in their food, but sometimes they'll get in their food. Sometimes I cook the ground beef and put it in their food. Sometimes I put it in there raw. I do put raw eggs in there with the shell. So always scrub your eggs before putting them in there. You don't want to give those babies anything that can set up bacteria or none of that. So wash your raw eggs very well, you guys. With the shell, put that in there. I add rice sometimes as a filler, and they do love rice. Sometimes I'll put beef broth in there, but y'all, water that ish down just to where you could get a hint of that beef flavor or whatever you use as far as broth, but because it can be salty. So you don't want to give them high blood pressure. You don't want to give them that sodium. So be careful with that. What else do I put in there? I put in there some dine, which is like extra calories and I think it has omega in it, omega 3. It has different types of vitamins in there. I also put coconut oil in their food for their coats, and it makes a difference, y'all. It really does. Sometimes I put, if I have them and if I remember to buy them, I'll put chicken livers in there. I love that ish. Yes, raw chicken livers. I never give my dogs like scraps from chicken, fried chicken or barbecue chicken. No, because they can choke on those bones. So you have to do your research. Far as their upkeep for their body, for, you know, their body, folds, make sure they're clean, make sure they're dry. Ears, make sure they're clean, make sure they're dry. Don't go all off in there digging, but you'll know if something's wrong with them ears, but keep them dry. When you're cleaning, when you're bathing them and all of that, make sure those ears are covered, and just at the end, make sure that you clean them and dry them out gently. Like I said, it's best to brush every day. If you can't do it every day, try to get it in as much as you can, because you're going to be the one suffering with those consequences with all the hair around the house. So brush. Teeth, they have toothbrush. So yeah, I try to remember to do their teeth. I can't say that I'm great with that, but that part. Bathing, I probably bathe them 3 to 4 times a month. I do. Each, what I said in another video, is each of them have different needs. Dundon is straightforward. She just has her cherry eye, which will be, like I said, we're going to get that fixed. It's just trying to get away from this schedule, and because it's cheaper to do it at a clinic in Oklahoma that we found, so we'll take her to do that. But that's the only issue that she has. I'm hoping she's pregnant. I'm kind of leaning towards she's not, so we'll figure that part out. This was her third cycle. Or her second. This was like her second full cycle to where I feel like it's regulating. And that was on August 1st when she had that, when it started. And I keep that documented on my calendar. I did an AI on the 6th, on the 9th, which I don't think was, it was trial and error. I know how to do it now though. So I did another artificial insemination on the 19th. I know I'm everywhere. I'm just saying it as I go. I didn't write it down or anything. Back to grooming. Make sure they're brushed. Make sure that tail pocket is clean, you guys. They're not your average bear. Like, they can't, before they come in the house, you want to make sure that their backside is clean, because they don't have a tail to swipe away all that extra ish. So you want to make sure their tail pockets are clean. Again, back to Dundun. The only real extra thing that I have to do, she can use regular shampoo. I use conditioner. So I use two, which I'll get in more detail later, but I use two shampoos and a conditioner on her. One of the shampoos is to keep her white. And one of them I just use because it has de-shedding stuff in it. So her eyes, I clean her eyes every day, twice a day, and I put drops in her eyes. This fold right here, y'all, because they have a smush face. I don't know how they get stuff in there, but it can be dirty. Sometimes it looks like somebody packed mud in there, but you got to clean that. I clean it every day. I clean it with a wet towel, with a little bit of like shampoo just for suds, their dog shampoo. I clean it, then I'll dry it. I'll clean it, dry it, witch hazel, dry it again. You want to make sure all those folds are clean. That tail pocket, you want to get underneath there, get you some gloves, get underneath there and make sure there's nothing impacted or, you know, under there that can cause discomfort or a smell. Her nails, y'all, my fault being a first time breeder, my error was I should have been clipping their nails from the get-go on a regular basis so that they were familiar with the clippers. And now it's a fight. It's a whole fight. But I'm going to have to do it today. I usually take them to Petco. And Petco will groom them for me, bathe them, and do their nails. But I'm in the mindset now that you're in the breeding game, boo. You're probably going to get some more dogs. I'm looking to probably get some Frenchies, two of them. Hopefully for one furry, furry carrier. But actually furry, you know. So I need to learn how to do these things myself because I don't want to see my profit walking out the door when there's something that I can learn to do myself. So yeah, I got to get that technique down. I have already started with Diddy doing his nails regularly. So because his breeder did and she let me know. So he's used to the clippers somewhat. So yeah, I'll just speed it up, but you guys can see how I groom her on a regular day. All right, here you guys. So I'm just gonna go ahead. I have a bucket of warm water next to me with some dog shampoo in there, a little just for the suds, and I'm gonna go in and clean her eyes. With her having the cherry eyes, she do sometimes have a little bit of discharge, so I'm gonna go ahead and clean those eyes really good. And y'all, it really does feel good to her. Look at that. That's the inside of that fold over her nose. It's actually looking pretty clean right now, y'all. You want to make sure you dry it back out because it can have, it can get bacteria that builds up in there. I'm just going ahead and taking off this bow she had on that she ripped off, that Nipsey ripped off her, so... But yeah, that's her eye drops. So I'm going to go ahead and put some eye drops in there. You're going to see me massaging those cherries back into the corner of her eyes. What they are tear ducts that have, I believe, dried out and now they are protruding on the outside. That can be very irritating. So what I'm doing right now is relaxing to her. I'm going to go ahead and push the cherries back in the corner. Sometimes this is the longest they've ever stayed in. And while I'm editing this video, it's like 4 hours later and they're still in. So that's dope. That's dope. And it's something that I do every day. Like I said, it's relaxing to her. It feels good. So she lets me do it. So you might see me about 5 or 6 times, you know, clean those eyes. I just like for them to be, her eyes are a beautiful color, y'all. They're like a greenish gray, some sort of color, but beautiful. Look at that coat. Do you see that little sheen on that coat? That's from eggs and the coconut oil. Now this brush right here is the brush that gets all the dry dead skin off their backs and the extra hair to lift. Look, it must have came back out, so I massaged it back in a couple of times, and she let me. Just make sure that if you do this technique that you moisturize the eyeball first to make it comfortable, and do not handle them roughly with their eyes. But like I said, it feels good to her, so she lets me do it with no problem. Those eyes are beautiful. All right, so I did take some witch hazel, you guys, and went in on that nose again, and it's really clean. I just like to go in and dry it out and all of that. Like I said, you don't want bacteria to set up. Go ahead and brush, brush, brush. Get off all the dead hair that you can. And she wanted to walk away, you guys. She hates that green brush. Now, this is their perfume. Well, not perfume, but deodorizing spray. I like to put that on them in between bathing to keep them fresh. Look, that cherry eye popped out again. So, I probably did it once or twice or more. But like I said, it feels good to her. So she didn't mind. Just make sure that your hands are clean. Do not go in doing this. I should have had on gloves. But yeah, make sure your hands are clean when you go to mess with their, you know, messing with their eyes and anything. Look at this. She likes this brush. This is like a regular brush. Look at her big body, y'all. She eats well. Look at her. So spoiled. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and put some clothes on her, y'all. She's gonna be mad. She hates it, y'all. She really does hate wearing clothes. You will see how she tries to get away. You're gonna see when she does get away that she's rubbing up against everything to try to get that shirt off. I'm gonna go ahead and put a new bow on her and we'll see how long it lasts. Look at her. She letting me right now, y'all, but she gonna get sick of me in a sec. All right, so next up, you'll see me taking out Diddy.
Ooh,
to go
that was a big
poop and pee. Y'all, he won't do it with the other two dogs. He plays too much.
Big.
He likes to play with them and forget what he's outside for. But let me know what you think about the video. Subscribe to True Kennels and share me out. Deuces.